Hi students, in the previous recorded sessions we discussed about a day in the ashram where I explained you the first page, that is paragraph number 1 and 2. We also understood about the author C.F. Andrews. He was a priest in the Church of England. He was a philosopher as well as an educator. He has also actively participated in the freedom struggle of our country, that is India. He has also helped, or he also supported, the ban of untouchability along with Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Right? Isn't it? And also we understood the word hymn. Hymn is nothing but a religious prayer. And also, yes, we understood choir as well as chorister. Like choir is a group of persons, an organized group of persons to sing religious songs. Is this clear? And these were the people who used to wake up early in the morning along with birds in Shantiniketan. Shantiniketan is the word coined by, the word given by Rabindranath Tagore. But actually it was founded by his father, Debendranath Tagore, in the year 1863. This is a small warm-up session. Like now, I hope you recalled or recollected whatever I had explained you in the previous session. Now open page number 3. Page number 3. First, I'll go through this one. First, reading activity will take place. Then we shall come back to explanation. After an interval, each boy takes his asana, his square of carpet, into the fields and sit down on it to meditate in his own place alone. Later on, before the schoolwork begins, the boys all stand together in the shade of the trees and sing their hymn. Till about 10:30, the work of the school goes on. We have no classrooms. The boys sit with their teachers in the open air under the trees. There are no larger classes. A group of 8 or 10 boys are seated around the teacher asking him questions. Very few books are used. A great part is carried on through conversation. The boys soon learn to open out all their difficulties to their teachers, and the teachers get keenly interested in the boys. Questions and answers. Such living education can never be done. After an interval, in the sense the boys will wake up, they go round the ashram so that they can sing the hymns and they wake up the people. After an interval, like as soon as they finish singing, they take a break, like they relax. Each boy takes his asana. Asana is square mat where people meditate on it. Like asana, usually we say it. Each boy takes his asana. Asana means where we sit on for meditation. Like there are many different asanas. There is Surya Namaskar, right? There are different types of asanas where, like, if one group is performing one asana, the other will perform the other asana. On which one they'll perform asanas? They'll perform on square mats. Usually they prefer square mats for asanas. Even these days also, people take up the square mat for asanas, for performing meditation, for performing yogas and all. Okay? His square carpet into the fields and sits down on it to meditate in his own place alone. They go on the fields. Shantiniketan is spread across like over 1,000 acres. The people, the students, they sit on their respective mats and they start performing asanas alone, because they are free from the outer world, the traffic, the pollution, the noise and all. They go into the field, because fields are very silent place. They go there, they perform their asanas on square mats. Later on, before the school work begins, see, this is in all the activities students are performing before the school begins. Like, imagine that the school begins at 10:30. They'll wake up before sunrise. They sing hymns and they go around the ashram to sing hymns. Later, they meditate or they perform yoga, and the boys all stand together in the shades of the tree and again sing their hymn. As soon as they finish the yoga or meditation, they stand under the shades of the trees, because by 7:30, or when it is summer, by 6:30, 6:45, the sun appears, isn't it? So they stand under the shades of the trees and they start singing the hymns. Again, they sing the religious songs till about 10:30. See, 10:30. Half past ten is 10:30. We have no class. The school goes on. Actually, the school begins at 10:30. They don't have how we have different classes for different, like fifth standard A section, B section, C section. In Shantiniketan, there are no classrooms. Students sit under the shades of trees. Have you seen in older movies and everything? This is a big tree, like they sit here. Students will sit here. They usually build a stone. If teacher is sitting here, the students will sit here under the shades of trees. We have no classrooms. They don't have classrooms. The boys sit with the teachers in the open air under the trees. They sit in an open environment and they sit under the shades of trees. There are no larger classes. Like, approximately, there are not strength of 100, 200, 50. A group of 8 or 10 boys are seated around the teacher asking him questions. There are only 8 to 10 boys that are accompanied by one teacher. See, there is no larger class. There are no larger classes means there are no 100, 200 strength or 50 strength. There's only 8 to 10 boys. They sit around the teacher, asking him few. They ask certain questions. Very few books are used. A greater part is carried on through conversation. How we carry a pile of books? They don't have such books. Actually, in conversation, they learn so many things. The boys soon learn to open out all their difficulties to their teachers. Like, if the teacher is sitting there, if they have any difficulty they are facing, they have psychological problem or they have mental problem, they have their own problems, they open up with teachers and the teachers, and the teacher try to solve the problems of students. Soon, and the teacher get keenly interested in the boys' questions and answers. Such living education can never be dull. See, here they are learning in an open environment. The teacher is accompanied by only 8 to 10 students. She is very much interested. She keenly means bahut dhyan se. She keenly listens to students. She tries to solve the problem of students. Here, such type of a learning can never be done. They learn with conversation. They don't become the bookworms as how we have become these days. We are relying on the textbooks. Isn't it? Right? So, but here, the education, the learning process was entirely different. They learn with great joy. They learn with experiments. Practical learning was actually taking place. The bond between a teacher and the student was also very different. Teacher was very much interested in the questions of students and she tries to answer it. If the students are facing any problem, the teacher would have helped it. Like that, the learning place was taking place in Shantiniketan with no formal classes. They were not having the formal classes, but they learn under the shades of trees in an open environment. Is this clear, children? Try to read the prose. You will understand it. If you don't, you can always contact me through WhatsApp. Any doubt, feel free to contact it. But make sure you watch the video and go through the textbooks for reading activity. Okay? Yes. So, study is stay home, study well. Bye.